for you to get started with crypto, you need to have a crypto wallet, and all of that is done through a Binance app. And I noticed that I went higher grade on my laptop and forgot that most users actually prefer to use a cell phone. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to use the app using the cell phones so that you can buy and trade anywhere, anytime. And without wasting time, let's go to my laptop.
Welcome, my name is Lindy Cherise, and in today's video, I'll go straight to my phone. So the very first thing that you need to go to your app store and install Binance. And then you just go to your app store and then go to search. And then if you're using Android, you go to your Android one, and then it will open Binance like that. And then you just click install. And then after installing, you'd have to open. So with mine, whenever I open Binance, I'll see a window like this. Then I'll click Binance. And then I have used Windows Authentication to open. And then when you get to the screen, don't be confused, because that's where most people get stuck. Just go to the wallet area and click Overview. So Overview will actually give you the whole amount of what you have. So as you see in my spot account here, I do have a certain amount, and then on my cross margin, I also have money. And then at the bottom under N, I did actually save some money. And then this is the interest I am earning daily, and this is for 30 days. So this is another way to earn. And then after clicking Overview, you can go to Sports, and then under Sports, you see what you currently have. Like on my BTC, this is what I have, and then BNB, BUSD, and then all the cryptocurrencies that you want. And then when you go to Withdraw, if you want to withdraw, you can actually come to this one and click BNB if you have your BNB, and then you'll have to specify a wallet address which is BNB. And then you can just press the wallet address here. And then after, you'll be able to withdraw. So transfer is when you want to transfer from one spot wallet into maybe your margin, or from your margin into your spot wallet. And then you are done with spot. And then let's go to margin, which is another type of trading, which I won't cover because this is a get started video. And then on futures, you use futures if you want to buy. So say, for example, when you trade, you're trading to buy something now, which is on the market or which is under limits as well at that price of the market. But then when you go to futures, you're actually buying, you're predicting that the future value of a coin like Bitcoin will be this price. And then if it's not that amount, then you lose. If it is that amount, then you will gain money. And then P2P, it's peer-to-peer trading. So say, for example, I want to buy a crypto from you, and then you can go and register with Binance, and then I'll be able to buy, but I will show you how to use it later. And then N is when you want to earn. So you can earn multiple ways. I do have a video which will tell you how to earn. So you can earn on staking, you can earn on interest when you're saving as well, you can use N. And then pool, it's when you save and then you earn from that pool as well. For example, I've saved my money, I think it's 500 and something. And then this is what I'm earning from that pool every day. And then gift is when you want to send a gift card to someone, you can create one and send it to someone. Or if someone gave you that gift card, you can actually redeem from here. And then let's go back to homepage right at the bottom where you see homepage. And then this is the screen that you're going to use. So if you ever get confused, just click home. It will take you to this screen. And then when you see the first one is deposit, say you have cryptos on maybe on your Trust wallet and you want to bring into your Binance account, you click deposit. And then you select the crypto that you want. Let's say maybe you want to send Atom. You can just click Atom. And then you can share the wallet address to that person or to your other, or to even to your WhatsApp, so that you can have that crypto address, or you can just copy it if you want to copy. So say, for example, BTC, I can just copy from this, which is this wallet address, and then go to my Luno or other wallet address and then send to here. So that's what you use for depositing. And then referral link is when you want to invite people into Binance, and then every time you invite them, you earn certain amount, or you save on your trading fees. And then in the savings is what I've just said, that I did add my money to save. So you can save TKO, which is another crypto. You can stake BTC as well. So there's flexible savings and then there's locked savings. So locked savings is when you specify 30 days and it is locked, and then flexible, you can withdraw anytime. So it also lists what percentage you're going to get when you are actually staking. And then there's different cryptos you can scroll down if you want to save. And then there's actually a more button on your right hand side, this one, and then you can just click more. So with more, you can actually do transfer from one crypto to another. You can do your deposit, you can do your orders. This is when you start trading, and then you can do convert. Let me just show you convert, because convert, you would use it often. So say now I decided I don't want my BTC, because I do have my BTC. I actually want to buy Ethereum. Say maybe Ethereum has dropped, then I would do that. And I can preview that and to see how much I would actually get. So when you click preview, it will show you how much you are actually going to get. And you have a few seconds to confirm. If you don't confirm, that code expires. You have to do a refresh to do another code. And then you also given, I think, 5 seconds as well to do confirm the conversion. And then let's go back. The stock token as well, the savings, as I said here, and then there's staking, and then there's pay, there's crypto loans. I do have a video that talks about crypto loan, where you can borrow money from Binance and actually use a collateral of your BNB to actually have a collateral, and then you can pay it back. Maybe you can do this for 7 days or 30 days. And I did actually once did use this crypto loan. And then you can also do liquid swap. And then there's Ethereum 2.0, where you can actually stake your Ethereum, your current Ethereum. So this is a future project that is coming in future. And then you can also do that. And there's also launch pads. Launch pads actually show you new cryptos that are actually coming. And then you can just go to launch pad. And then this one is on number 4. On others, at the bottom, number 4, you can see Launchpad. Launchpad is new cryptos which are coming, and then you can see that as well. It also refused to open. So, but then let me show you what you're going to need the most when you get started. Obviously, you want to buy your cryptos. So you're starting, you go to your homepage, and then you go to your wallet, and then you select the crypto that you want. So let's say you want to buy Bitcoin, you click Bitcoin. And then it opens. And then there's a lot of things you can do. You can buy with P2P, which is peer-to-peer, which it doesn't have any fees. Or you can buy with your credit card. So let's start with your credit card. And then you click buy with a credit card. And then you select the crypto that you want. And then you specify. And then if you say $100, and then it will specify $100. And then you can specify ZAR if you want to use South African rands. And then it will convert so that you can see, and it will tell you what minimum amount you can buy. So for South African rands, you can buy with 300 rand, and then you just continue, and then it will ask for your credit card details, and then you will continue from there. And then just to refresh you guys, you go to your homepage, you go to your wallets, and then you select the crypto that you want to buy, and then you select buy with credit card, and you specify the amount, and then it will tell you what amount is the minimum, and then you can specify. If you do have ZAR and want to change to USD, you can just click here and type USD, and then you can go easily go back to USD, and then you can specify the money, and then you click continue. And then the second way to buy, which I still need to record a video tomorrow, I'll record a video on this, is P2P. So say for example my bank doesn't allow me to buy using my bank card. So now I'll use P2P. So buy from someone. So these are verified people who are verified by Binance, and then we can buy. So there are a few cryptos which you can buy. You can buy USDT, BTC, BSD, BNB, Ethereum, and DAI. Say I want to buy Ethereum. I can just click buy at the top and then select whoever I want. So those with a tick, like FabZeb, this person is actually verified to sell crypto on Binance. So what you do, you click buy. And then when you click buy, it will tell you how you're going to deposit the money. Okay, sometimes these people are actually international, sometimes are local. So like if you're in South Africa, you can use your FNB or instant cash to deposit the money to that person. And then after that person will transfer crypto. But you do need to do it so fast like maybe when you're ready to buy, make sure that you are closer to an ATM where you can do an instant cash, or you are ready to transfer using the same bank that the person is using. So you can select what you want to use. So for example, you go at the top and you select USDC, or you can select ZAS, because we want people who are actually using South African bank accounts. So it'll go and select all those people who are in South Africa and who are also selling. And then you can see. And then when you click buy from that person, say I'm buying USDT, and then it'll specify how I'm going to pay this person. And then it'll say payment window, and right at the bottom it's 15 minutes. And then the seller's name is JT. And then you can do a bank transfer. And then when you see at the bottom, it says terms. So FNB fast release, please pay and clear from other bank. Use your name as a reference. So you do need to follow exactly what this person is saying. So you cannot use Standard Bank because he said FNB fast payment, because the money needs to be cleared from his side before he can release. But don't worry, you are protected by Binance. You cannot just disappear with your money. Binance will send the cryptos if it decides it doesn't want to pay you your money. So you don't need to worry about that. And I'll do record a full video on that. So that's P2P. And then go to trade. And then trading works with pairs. So for example, BTC and AUD. So there's different pairs for different trading. So when you go back and then you go to, when you go back and go to markets and then you select spot or futures, so depending on what you want. So I usually go on spot, and then you can see the different prices for different pairs. And then you can select, say I want to trade Ethereum, and then it will show you the different kinds of trading pairs that are available for Ethereum. So for Ethereum, you can see it's USDT, which is a stable coin, and then which actually has a lot of market cap as well. So a stable coin is the one that's also equivalent to $1. So it is stable, doesn't move like your Ethereum, which can go up and down. And then BUSD is another stable coin, and also Ethereum USDC is also another stable coin. So you can choose the trading pair that you want. Say I chose Ethereum and USDC. It will show you a trading window where you can trade. So you can either buy your under your order book, or you can sell. And then you can also see your market history, your margin data. And then under your order book as well, it shows you who are the people who are selling and also buying. So these are the people who are selling and buying on this pair, currency pair, Ethereum USDC. So when you want to buy, you can just click buy, and it will go and show you the amount that you have under USDT, USDC and Ethereum. So for example, if you want to buy Ethereum, you will click buy. And then when you click buy Ethereum, it will show you how much you have available here at the bottom where there's a plus sign. And then it will show you how much you have. And then you can just click buy Ethereum. And then it will just buy. And then when you want to sell, you can sell Ethereum. So basically when you sell, you're selling Ethereum to USDC. So that's trading as well. And then you can go to futures as well and do the same trading, but then with futures it's more risky. Don't go there unless if you have more knowledge. And then let's go to wallets. So I'm now ending the video so that I can remind you guys what you need. The main thing that you need to go to home, and then you do need to go to more as well, and then you can see more information on different things that you can do. But then if you want to buy, you go to wallets, and then you go to spot, and then you select the crypto that you want to buy, and then you buy with a credit card or with P2P. But then if you want to trade, and then you click trade, and then it will take you there. And then you can also convert from one crypto to another. You can also do a spot trading, which will also do a market or a limits as well, a stop limits as well. So you do have those options, but we'll go into detail for you to understand. So I hope you understand how to buy. For the last time, to buy crypto, you go to home, you go to wallets, and then you select the crypto that you want to buy, and then you can buy with credit card or P2P. So I hope you see how to use this app. And then to see overview of everything that you have, you just click overview. So the main four things that you would use here for now, it's overview to see everything that you have, because you can buy these different cryptos. And then spots is all your cryptos that you have. And then also, if you want to buy, you go here. And then margin futures is when you start trading. P2P, if you want to buy crypto from another peer, someone who's registered with Binance, you go to P2P. And it's when you want to stake, and also when you want to save, you will go here. For example, you can see I've saved this amount. I've saved my USDT. And as you can see, and this is the accumulative interest that I am getting daily. So that's also something that you will also need. And to trade, you go to trading at the bottom. And then that's it, guys. I think for today, for those who are starting, you can use this app easy. Thank you so much for watching. And please don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell notification, and share the video with many people. We are going to know this crypto. Thank you so much for your support.